So one person joined, but the time is already up, so we will start the lecture.
우리 에디피아가 참 이게 인터넷 이런 전력 사정이 안 좋아서 이렇게 메시지 하기가 전달이 어려운 그런 상황입니다.
Ethiopia is the internet network and the electricity condition is not good, so it is a little difficult to deliver the messages.
예, 그래서 여러분 기도 많이 하셔야 돼요.
So we need your prayer so much.
지금은 이런 방법 외에는 여러분 나라에 복음 전할 수 있는 길이 없어요.
In these days, using this online, without this online, it is difficult to deliver the messages in your country.
예, 여러분 나라 사정이 안 좋은 걸 좀 여러 가지 어려운 걸 알고 있습니다.
I already know your country's situation is not that much good electricity and network.
예, 그래서 뭐 하나님이 또 여러분이 아마 이 복음 받을 사람이 있기 때문에 어쨌든 복음 전달할 수 있도록 그런 역사할 줄 믿습니다.
But I believe surely there is some person. God wants for that person to receive this message. Because of that, God will work. I believe that.
자, 오늘 내일 또 제가 이 담당인데 같이 또 우리 기도하면서 하나님 주신 말씀 나눠야 되겠죠.
Okay. Today and tomorrow I will deliver the lecture. So with a prayer, we will share the message which God gives us.
역사적으로 에디오피아는 사실은 복음을 가장 일찍 받은 나라입니다.
Historically, Ethiopia is the, you know, country which received the gospel message earlier.
아시는지 모르겠지만은 성경을 보면 사도행전 8장에 26절 이하에 보면 에디오피아 넷이라고 나라와 그 또 사람 이름 그 뭐야 왕의 국고를 막은 넷이 나와 있습니다.
Okay. When you see Acts chapter 8, there the Ethiopian eunuch comes out. He received the gospel message.
그리고 그보다 더 앞서서 솔로몬 시대도 그래서 이게 부수 수바 왕이 나옵니다.
Okay. Previously, that already in Solomon's time, Queen Sheba, she also had some relationship with Israel.
그러니까 뭐 벌써 참 이 초기부터 이렇게 벌써 이스라엘하고 교류하면서.
So from the early stage, Ethiopia have a fellowship connection with Israel.
이렇게 사실은 일찍이 복음 받은 나라인데. 지금은 에디오피아가 복음이 없는 나라가 되세요.
Now, frankly, Ethiopia received the gospel message a very earlier time, but now the gospel, this gospel was disappeared in Ethiopia.
또 뭐 한국이 전쟁할 때 완전히 나라가 망했을 때 에디오피아는 도와주었던 나라였습니다.
And when Korea has a Korean War, Korea is nearly, you know, a perishing moment. Ethiopia support us, so helped Korea.
근데 한국은 지금 세계 복음화하는데 에디오피아는 지금 복음이 없는 나라예요.
But now Korea is doing world evangelization, but Ethiopia become the country the gospel disappeared.
에디오피아가 얼마만큼 어려운지 지금 우리가 보면 인터넷도 안 돼가지고 메시지하기 어려울 정도로.
How difficult your country's situation is, even because of electricity and network situation, condition, even it is a little difficult to deliver the message.
그러니까 우리가 빨리 기다려야 됩니다. 그냥 그런 걸로 우리가 잘하고 하나 이렇게 하면 되고 보험이 되는 거 나온 거예요.
So we should quickly understand this. Whenever this gospel is disappeared, God works to restore this gospel.
Yeah.
So every moment that God leaves behind just a pure person to restore his gospel. Why? God's absolute plan is world evangelization. So, and the evangelization, that is God's absolute plan. The Satan tried to block it, but he cannot block it. So whenever the disaster comes, we should be able to see the time scale God wants to restore his gospel. Because of this, even in this difficult situation, we want to do the gospel restoration movement. Just a few people, it is okay. Even God uses just a few persons that he did word evangelization. We save those people, the remained ones. I believe, Mr. Biro, you are that person who received that blessing.
So you receive this gospel message and deliver it in your country and in Ethiopia and restore the gospel. Then Ethiopia is a very important country to deliver this gospel messages around other African countries and even Middle East countries.
Africa and also, you know, even the eastern area, eastern countries, the Oriental Orthodox influenced those countries so much. But they say that is also Christianity. In Ethiopia, you have an Ethiopian Orthodox, and there are, you know, even Syrian Orthodox.
Yeah.